in the 2021 NFL Draft, the Dallas Cowboys select Michael Parsons. Woo! Linebacker, Penn State. Yes!
I think this is also a good point for us to mention that Drew Pearson is slated to make the pick for the Cowboys tomorrow.
There we go.
So Micah Parsons from Harrisburg, PA, and he played at Penn State, where Sean Lee played. And as we know, he just retired after many meritorious but injury-marred years in Dallas. He now joins Leighton Vander Esch and Jalen Smith to, as you point out, it's front dependent, that's front seven dependent right there, and he is a heck of a player coming to Dallas.
And he can run and cover all day long. Running backs and tight ends is not an issue. You can line him up anywhere you want. Dan Quinn's going to have fun with him as a chess piece. And he's a dynamic blitzer. I'm not convinced you couldn't just line him up and let him rush the quarterback. He might be a double-digit sack guy. He's that good coming off the edge.
And DJ, think about what Washington has done now with Logan Thomas increasing at tight end. Philadelphia still has there, too, with Ertz and Goddard. So being able to defend those guys as well as come off the edge is kind of like Dante Hightower when he was with New England.
My notes, blitzer, A+. Run defender, A+. Pass coverage, A+. This guy is fast, he's explosive, he is downhill, and he will shine in this defense. There's no question about it. Hopefully the commissioner's going to be all right. But this guy is unbelievable. I was texting with James Franklin earlier, just wondering who was going to get this guy. This is a perfect fit.
Micah Parsons just went officer and a gentleman on the commissioner, I think, almost right there.
The good news, if he tweaks his back, he's got a comfortable chair to sit in.
Yes, he does.
He's just fine.
Well, I mean, if the fans get out of it, but this kid is really good, man.
Yeah, I just mentioned it. This guy can do anything you want on a football field. Coach mentioned him being fast. Not kind of fast. 4.36 40 speed at 246 pounds. That's not normal, by the way, to be that big and that explosive. When you watch him on video at Penn State, you really can't take your eyes off him. It's hard to find linebackers who can get off blocks. This guy comes downhill, uses his hands. He can shock and shed and get to the ball carrier. He's not an avoid and ignore guy off the ball. Here he is off the edge. Does show you some of that athleticism to be able to rip through and slip through the block and make a play in the backfield. The range is legitimate sideline to sideline range. Something Leighton Vander Esch does very well with his range as well. He's going to fit in, and here's the blitzing. This is what I referenced a little bit earlier. When he puts his foot in the ground and decides to go, he gets from A to B immediately to create pressure. Coming off the edge here, if he was just an edge rusher, I think he'd be one of the top three or four edge rushers in the draft. There's the blitz. There's the speed. It shows up in Penn State. Did not play this last year. He was an opt-out. If you're worried about what he might look like after a year off, go watch his pro day. It's one of the best linebacker pro days I've ever seen.
Yeah, you know, Ryan Shazier had that type of speed coming out of Ohio State. He wore number 11 like LeVar Arrington. But here's my comp for him. Jalen Smith, a guy that he's going to join now, because remember before Jalen Smith hurt his knee,